Hi, this is Nancy Schick, attorney, mediator, and conflict resolution coach in New York City. My goal is to keep you out of court and build your conflict resolution skills. So the past couple of weeks, I've been talking a lot about workplace dating because that is where a lot of the sexual harassment complaints that we see start, right? It starts with that workplace relationship that goes bad, and all of us that have done that, and I've been one of them, right, is if we think it's going to work out fine in the beginning, and sometimes it does. But how do you correct then that lapse in judgment, right? We know at this point approximately 40% of people are having relationships in the workplace, and then sometimes we make that decision that we regret. So what do you do if you made that move that you now regret? I'm a fan of doing what Abe Lincoln says, is that if you want to create the future, then, or if you want, the best way to control it is to create it, right? So I agree with that. And I'm going to say, don't do what a lot of people do. Don't freeze and hope that it'll fix itself, because that's very unlikely to happen that way. So the first thing you want to do is take ownership of the act that you took, right? So maybe it was at the holiday party, you had a little too much to drink, and somebody you've been sort of attracted to, you engaged in some sort of behavior with, something along those lines. And maybe you now regret it. So just own that, hey, in that moment, I made a decision that I should have thought through and I didn't. And here's what I'm going to do, right? You want to have a complete apology and a complete ownership. You want to say, I'm sorry that I made that decision. Here's what I'm going to do to make sure that this never happens again. And then you want to do what you said you're going to do. Second, you want to open a discussion with all of the parties involved, and that may include your management, human resources, or possibly, depending on how far it went, you may even want to talk to an attorney. Third, you want to co-create a resolution with those parties that we mentioned. You don't want to choose what you think needs to happen and then force it on everybody else, right? A discussion is you open a conversation and say, hey, I realize this got out of hand and we need to talk about how to resolve it because I want to continue working with you and we need to do this in an effective way, right? So this is not an easy topic. I know that. And I've had a lot of comments on my videos that I've been doing saying, no, just don't date in the workplace. But again, I'm a realist. I see that 40% statistic. And I know a lot of us are doing this. I'm not anymore, right? And part of that's because I realize the risk is a lot greater than the reward. And I'm in a relationship, right? But these are the kinds of things that you want to think about. If you've got questions about sexual harassment prevention, I'll put a link to my online course in the notes. And of course, if you're in a situation that you need some coaching, you can also reach out to me and you'll see my contact information on the screen. Let's make this your best year yet.